Praise the Lord and good evening to you all. You know that song, even though I didn't sing it, right? You are great. You do miracles so great. Welcome to An Hour with Jesus. I'm so glad you're here. It's been quite a week. You know, last week, Miss Liz was way under the weather, so much that she couldn't even operate the cameras for us. And she's still battling, but she is here tonight on the way back out of it, and I'm so glad for that. I joined the sick club and am suffering with strep throat right now myself, along with a cold, and so I am not in singing form tonight. Believe me, I might sing a little tiny bit here and there, but you don't want to hear a lot of it. I promise you that. Things are just really whacked up in there. So it's been with me about six days now. But I'm on some medication that's supposed to get rid of it. And what I'm really grateful for is if this thing was going to come on both of us, much better now than 2 weeks from tomorrow when we get on a plane to go to South Africa for 20 days. Need to be healthy and carry on the plans of God down there. So I'm seeing a silver lining in the cloud, basically. God is always up to something good. So pray for us, if you will, that all the germs take exit out of this house and we are totally restored to health. So tonight, we're going to do a little sing-along with the CDs. And I'll play a little bit with it, and we'll just have a good time together. Now, I was going to do a special request show this coming Saturday. Let's push that back a week to next week, and I should be back in full voice as my wife is coughing off in the distance. I should be back in full voice by the grace of God next Saturday. So not this weekend, but next weekend we will shoot for that show so you can get your requests sent in, and we'll take care of that. That will begin at 11 a.m. Central Time. So instead of doing the replay then, we'll be doing a live show 11 o'clock on Saturday next weekend. All right, I think that's probably about it. How are you all doing? You know, I was so tempted because I've been feeling so poorly to just tell Robin, let's put on another show that we have in the can for reserve for times like this. And I thought, no, the people of God are coming out to watch this and participate, and they need touch of His presence. And so I'm all right. I'm not where I want to be physically, but I just couldn't pass up the opportunity to be with the most wonderful worship church in the world, our global worship church, as we call it. So I'm glad that you're here. I really am, and I know several hundred more folks will be watching in the next several hours, if it's like it usually is, and then another 1,000 or so will be watching it overnight and tomorrow. And so thank you for tuning in. And I hope that God just touches you tonight, even though this is a little bit of a different kind of show this evening. I hope He touches you. It's all about His Holy Spirit, and I can't touch you anyway. It's always the Lord that touches you, and He hasn't changed. Isn't that great? Praise God. All right, well, let's just kind of get into this a little bit. And just see what happens tonight. This song from my second live album. Just a favorite song. I still love singing it all these years later. So simple. I love you, my Lord.
Sing this simple little chorus together. I love you.
I love you.
song right now. Everyone together, just lending your voices.
Hallelujah.
And worshiping the Lord.
Yes, Lord, we worship you.
Oh, if you've never done it, just sing a song of praise.
So many years ago.
So beautiful is the song of the bride.
People of God.
So lovely is the song you sing.
The worshipers of the Lamb.
So beautiful is the song.
Thank you so much, Lord, for the freedom of worship. Back great memories of the World Prayer Center back in the early, well, late 1990s and early 2000. Wonderful times we had. So grateful for those marking points in our lives where God was so real and so rich. Praise God. I think I can still play.
Thank you.
quiet place, far from the rapid pace. Oh, thank you, Lord, for the solitude of that peaceful, quiet place with you. You always show up when we take the time to steal away with you, Father, and I'm so thankful for that. What a attending friend you are in all situations. Praise the Lord.
You're my glory.
Yes.
And the lifter of my head.
Let his presence just come into your room right now.
You're my glory, Lord. And the lifter of my head. For thou, Lord, art a shield for me.
Yes, you are.
My glory and the glory and the lifter of
Hallelujah.
Our heads. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Wow. Did that bless you? Because it blessed me. Goodness, that was recorded probably close to 20 years ago now. 19 at least. And I remember the night, and I remember the power and the presence in the room. And you can still feel it. And you know what's so strange? I wrote that song several years before that. And when we were putting this live service together, I needed another song. And so on a whim, I grabbed that old song that I had written several years before just to fill the CD a little bit more. And don't you know, it was one of the most powerful expressions on the CD. You see, when we decrease, he increases. And it's so important to continue to understand that nothing that comes, that's good, that comes out of us is really us. It's all God. God gave the song, God put the anointing on it, and God put the blessing on it when we sang it to him. To him be all the glory and all the honor. Hallelujah. Wow. Whew. See, I don't even have to sing for him to show up. Oh, beautiful old hymn now.
Fairest Lord Jesus, worship him. Thank you. Lord, that every nation on the earth worship you. Let a fresh wind of your Spirit blow across this entire earth with the glory and honor of the Father, the praise and adoration of the Son. Hallelujah. Scripture chorus I ever learned. Thou art worthy.
Sing it.
For thou hast created, as all things created, thou hast created all
thank you.
Jesus.
Strength and dominion is yours, both now and forevermore.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Worthy.
Yes, you are. Wow, wow, wow.
Thank you, Lord.
What an expression down in the island of Trinidad. That precious congregation of worshipers, loud singers, beautiful singers of the majesty of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. Wow. Thank you. Praise the Lord. I hope you're enjoying this different kind of an evening. I'm enjoying it. Praise the Lord. Let's open the scriptures for a couple minutes tonight. Book of John, 4th chapter. The book of John, the 4th chapter, with the Amplified Version in front of me. Love this chapter. Jesus Goes to Galilee is the title in this translation. Verse 1. So when the Lord learned that the Pharisees had been told that Jesus was making and baptizing more disciples than John, although Jesus himself was not baptizing, but his disciples were, he left Judea and returned again to Galilee. Now he had to go through Samaria, so he arrived at a Samaritan town called Sychar, near the tract of land that Jacob gave to his son Joseph, and Jacob's well was there. So Jesus, tired as he was from his journey, sat down by the well. It was then about the 6th hour, which is noontime. Then a woman from Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Hey, give me a drink." For his disciples had gone off into the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman asked him, "How is it that you, being a Jew, are asking me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink?" For Jews had nothing to do with Samaritans. Jesus answered her, "If you knew about God's gift of eternal life and who it is who says, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him instead, and he would have given you living water, eternal life." She said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, no bucket and rope, and the well is deep. Where then do you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well, and who used to drink from it himself, and his sons, and his cattle also?" Jesus answered her, and if I could paraphrase, he's answering her saying, you're not getting what I'm saying. You're looking through the wrong eyes. Look through your spirit eyes, lady. All right, end of my little paraphrase. Jesus answered her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water that I give him will never be thirsty again. But the water that I give him will become in him a spring of water, satisfying his thirst for God, welling up continually, flowing, bubbling within him to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I will not get thirsty nor have to continually come all the way here to draw." At this, let me paraphrase again, Jesus looked at her and said, "You're not getting it. You're still looking through natural eyes. It's not about this well. It's not about Jacob. It's not about having the right tools to draw the water with. It's not even about a special kind of earthly water where you can drink it once and not get thirsty. No, lady." So he's thinking to himself, if I can continue to think on Jesus's thought line for a minute, which is dangerous for a guy like me, he thinks, "I'm going to go a different direction." He says, "Go call your husband and come back." The woman answered, "I do not have a husband." Jesus said to her, "You have correctly said, 'I do not have a husband,' for you have had five husbands, haven't you, lady? In fact, the man you're with now is not your husband. You have said this truthfully." The woman said to him, "Sir, I see now that you are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, but you Jews say that the place where one ought to worship is in Jerusalem, at the temple." Jesus replied, "Woman, believe me, the time is coming when God's kingdom comes, when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans do not know what you worship. We Jews do know what we worship, for salvation is from the Jews. But a time is coming and is already here when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit, from the heart, the inner self, and in truth, for the Father seeks such people to be his worshipers." So, lady, I'm not talking about going and making a public display in the temple. I'm talking about what's in here. The true worshipers worship him in spirit and in truth. God is spirit, the source of life, yet invisible to mankind. And those who worship him truly must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to him, "I know that Messiah is coming, he who is called Christ the Anointed. When that one comes, he will tell us everything we need to know." Jesus said to her, oh, I love this. "I who speak to you am he, the Messiah." I think it's at this point where this lady comes undone, because everything he has told her has been true. And now she's thinking, "I can't even question this. You are he who you say, who says who he is. You are the Messiah." Just then his disciples came and they were surprised to find him talking with the woman. However, no one said, what are you asking about or why are you talking to her? Then the woman left her water jar and went into the city and began telling the people, come see a man. You've got to come see this man who told me all the things that I have done. Can this be Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed? So the people left the city and were coming to him. Meanwhile, the disciples were urging Jesus to have a meal, saying, Rabbi, eat. But he told them, I have food to eat that you do not know about. Goes on from there. But what a wonderful story. You see, Jesus is looking through different eyes than you and I. And he's trying his whole life ministry on the earth, trying to teach those around him. You're looking through the wrong eyes. Lady, I have water that doesn't come from a well. And if you'll drink of that water, you'll stop sleeping with other men who aren't your husband. You'll stop having husband after husband. You will never thirst again because my water is the water of life. My water is from the wells of salvation. Draw from that well, and you will never thirst again. Hallelujah. Friends, we've got to open our spiritual eyes. This is why I'm a charismatic and not just a straight-laced whatever else, because I have to be involved with the Spirit of God, the living, breathing, on the earth Spirit of the Lord. He has to be present in my services. He has to be present in my ministry. That's why I've gone the path that I've gone, because I sensed life there. And with all the baggage that some of that brings with it, there is still life there. And I'm out to pursue that life more than anything else. I have to have it. We're going to South Africa in 2 weeks. And my purpose is this, not to have 10 services, but to find the presence and power of God at some point in each one of those 10 services. I don't want to just sing songs and have a happy time together. I want the engagement in this critical hour on the earth of the Spirit of the living God touching, healing, changing hearts of men, bringing lost ones into the kingdom if they're present in those services. That's why New Glory International exists. Thank you, so many of you that give monthly to this or periodically to this ministry. That helps us. We so appreciate it. We couldn't do what we do without the people of God. But we must look through our spirit eyes. There was a song back in the 70s by a Christian rock group. They were a rock group, and I didn't care for them at all. It was called Ron Salisbury and the JC Power Outlet, and they got on with it. It was rock with Christian words attached to it. Not my style, as you well know by now. But they also had this one song that hooked me when I was at this huge music outdoor conference called ICTHUS in Wilmore, Kentucky. There was 15,000 people there every year for several years. And this beautiful little chorus, which deals with what I just talked about, went like this. Open your spiritual eyes and see the love of Jesus. Your heart and let his light shine right on through. Open your spiritual ears still small voice telling you right now that he loves you. Can I sing it one more time? Open your spiritual eyes, see the love of Jesus. Open your spiritual eyes. I hope that was a blessing to someone tonight. Open your heart and let his light shine right on through. Open your spiritual ears. Friends, open your spiritual ears. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. And hear his still small voice telling you right now that he loves you. Praise God. It's been a joy to be with you. Thanks for hanging with me tonight. Thanks for putting up with a less than 100% T-Mac here tonight. But we got through it, and I certainly felt his presence, which always amazes me. And I just am so grateful the Lord shows up to these Wednesday weekly hours with Jesus. It's not about Jesus, it's with Jesus. Yeah, it's about him, but we're with him. He's right here in our midst. And that's so exciting. Hey, visit the website, newglory.org. You can find out more about the ministry or make a donation there if God puts that on your heart. Just want you to know, we love and appreciate every one of you that tunes into this program every week. So grateful for you. A week from Saturday, we'll try to do a special request time, all right? So you tune into that, 11 o'clock, and it'll be a blessing. Think of the old songs you haven't heard for a while, and we'll try to catch that, all right? So let's go out tonight with a song from the Visit Us album so many years ago. People love singing this. Come, Holy Spirit, move in your people. Hallelujah. Rain down from heaven, fresh living water, bring us your liberty. Sing it over the body of Christ. Come, Holy Spirit. Yes, Lord. Touch every person who's watching this. Refresh them, Lord, as they sleep tonight. Until we see you again here, there, or in the hour, or in the air, God bless you and bye-bye for now.